Hi, in Simulation Girl, Jean here. Today we're gonna do fruit crepe cake. Okay, yes, I showed it before long time ago, and yes, it's very pathetic. I only got like 200 plus views lah. That's not the point. The point here is I am redoing this because I'm cutting away all the nonsense, and you'll see here in this new video is the complete version without dilly dala all. It has all the hacks, the shortcuts for you to do this fruit crepe cake. You don't need baking tools or an oven or a mixer. Basic kitchen stuff can do already one. Okay, let's go. Okay, for first, we're gonna do the crepe batter first. 2 cups of all-purpose flour, followed by 1 cup of sugar. I'm using white crystal sugar because I don't want my crepe to appear like brown or other color lah. Next, about 1/2 teaspoon of salt. So it's like kiamti like that. And then crack 2 eggs into it. And then 1/2 block or 100 grams of melted butter. I actually didn't wait until the butter melt lah. I microwave it only. 30 seconds only ah, not too long ah. 1 tablespoon of baking powder. A few drops of vanilla essence. The measurement tool says that it's a pinch lah. So you pandai, okay? But don't go and pinch the vanilla essence lah. It's not like you can pinch it, right? Okay, last. 2.5 cups of milk. Okay, you don't see me adding 2.5 cups, but it is 2.5 cups of milk because I only add more later on. So gao sebati, which means mix very well until there are no clumps in this batter. Heat up a flat round non-stick pan and then grease on some butter lah. Okay, you need 13 layers of crepes. This bowl of batter should give you about 15 like that lah. Got 2 spare, huh? Okay, you guys see how I swirl the pan? So you need a full ladle of batter and must swirl around. Work on your wrist power and make a good flat round crepe. After 2-3 minutes like that, your crepe should be cooked at the bottom ready. That's when you can check and then flip the other way around to cook the other side. Oop. Ah, shantik! That's why I say non-stick pan is very crucial in making these crepes. Ah, you see? Nice soft crepe. 1 down, 40 more to go. Okay, quick recap. Grease the pan with butter and then work your wrist by swirling around when pouring in the batter. If not enough the batter, you can still pour fun. Means you can fix it by adding a bit more. Not too much. We want a flat punya crepe. Everything is the same. 2-3 minutes, bottom should be cooked, and then flip the other way around. Ah, cantik sekali this one. Okay, and then continue cook for another 2-3 minutes for the other side and then take out. Just keep cooking the crepes until the batter habis. Okay, even though my crepes look quite uniform, but we still need to trim it to look like perfectly uniformed. So how we're gonna do is find a plate or even a bowl that is not too small, okay? It's just about the size of the crepe that we have. And then just put it on top and then take a knife and trim off the sides. And then what you do is eat off the sides that you already trimmed off, or just give it to someone to eat it lah. Okay, next, on to the whipping cream. Okay, we need 1 liter punya, usually comes in box punya whipped cream lah. Any brand will do. You need to refrigerate it and make it cold. Pour it into a blender about 1/3 full. And then add in a few drops of vanilla essence, 1/2 cup of icing sugar, and then blend it. Okay, why only 1/3 full eh? Because this whipped cream will kembang mah, it will expand and then become whipped cream because it will trap the air into becoming whipped cream. Also, trust the process. It will take a while to really form into whipped cream, but it's only about, say, 4-5 minutes or so. Just keep checking, and when it form into whipped cream like this, just stop whisking it, or should I say blending it, because when you blend more, it will become butter. Just keep blending until you finish the whole 1 liter box of whipped cream, okay? It is very crucial that you keep the whipped cream cold, especially before blending in. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very ugly diagram, but it's a very useful reference, okay? Orange line is crepe layers and pink springy lines are fruits. In between all the layers must be whipped cream, okay? Before we start anything, smudge a bit of whipped cream on a flat plate and then put on your first layer of crepe, and then goes another layer of whipped cream, and then another layer of the crepe, following exactly how the diagram shows, okay? Two layers of crepes and then followed by the first layer of fruit. Okay, when you're at the fruit layer, right, you need to first apply a thin layer of whipped cream on the crepe first, and then only you put on your fruits. Why leh? Because that is to hold the fruits together so that it won't run around. It's not like the fruits have legs and run around lah, but you know what I mean lah, right? Okay, if according to the diagram, we need 4 types of fruits. I am using pineapple cubes as my first layer of fruits. When you're done placing the fruits on the crepe, put on a few dollops of whipped creams on the fruit, and then only use your spatula to spread the cream evenly around to create a flat surface. And then just follow what the diagram shows and then just keep doing. So after that fruit layer, it should be another 3 layers of crepes. Again, don't forget your whipped cream, and then form a stable foundation when you're doing the fruits so that it can hold the fruits together while you're placing them, and then put a few dollops on top, spread it around, make a flat surface, and then tutup with another layer of crepes. And the thing is, it's really up to you. You can use any fruits you like, but my advice would be use the fruits that are vibrant in color so that it contributes in the aesthetic look of the cake. Fruits that you can consider are like orange, kiwi, strawberries, grape, peach, or even those African mangoes that is vibrant orange, that one. I use pineapple, grape, pear, and then lastly peach. It's not great combinations because I have limited choice when I was in Mauritania. When we slice open the cake, the aesthetic look of it is not that great lah, but taste-wise, it's great. Actually, I should say awesome lah. In fact, I make this cake twice in a month due to popular demand by my friends lah. Oh yeah, yes guys, this is my last layer of fruit, right? I'm using peach, and you can see I was actually struggling with the whipped cream because I was really out of it. I used too much at the bottom, so this is a reminder to everybody. Please, please use the whipped cream sparingly so that you have enough for your entire cake. We do not need more than 1 liter of whipped cream, okay? 1 liter is enough. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you are seeing me scraping off the excessive whipped cream at the side, but actually, I'm done with the cake. All I need to do is just dust some icing sugar on top of this cake so it looks prettier lah, in a way. This one macam fulfilling Christmas like that. Okay, in fact, I even add on some rainbow sprinkles at the side of the cake because I just need to finish them off. Ta-da! Now I'm really, really, really done. Hey guys, fun fact, when you're done with this cake, right, when you try to carry the cake, right, it's actually super duper heavy. You can see this is me and my friends. We are presenting the cake to a friend who is her birthday. Oh, but I forgot my knife. Okay, got my knife, joining back the crowd. Okay, this was when we are still in Mauritania, and then we need a different kind of knife, a fruit knife, okay? A cake knife wouldn't cut through all the fruits, so it's important that when you are serving this cake, you serve it with a fruit knife as well. So when it slices through, it will slice through and through. Okay, that's all for this time guys. I've already did this cake for so many times, and I hope you guys will try it. Trust me, it's really, really good. Okay, I'll see you next time. Bye!